So we got to talk about something. And there seems to be an elephant in the room. So anyways, you guys, this beautiful, beautiful work of art behind me that is known as the poster for GTA 6 was dropped yesterday. Somebody turned around at about 2 o'clock in the afternoon or 2:30 and leaked the GTA 6 trailer. So instead of getting the trailer today, December 5th at 6 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, we got the trailer. We were graced with the trailer basically 14 hours early. Rockstar turned around and released the trailer to the public yesterday. So today's video, I was planning on doing a reaction to this trailer because I can't remember the last time there was this much hype behind a trailer for a game. I think the last time I saw this was probably Red Dead Redemption 2. So, of course, every year they do the, you know, Call of Duty trailers. So, like, you know, every year you know Call of Duty is going to come out in October. So, you're going to get a trailer in, like, June, August time frame to kind of hype you up and get ready for the new game. But this is the first time we're getting a look at GTA 6. Now, mind you, this is all basically cutscenes. So, it's game engine work. It's not gameplay. I'm kind of disappointed we're not getting any gameplay trailers yet, considering how long this game has been in development for. I think that we should have gotten some kind of gameplay footage from this, but we're not. I'll just settle with this. So let's get into it. Let's check this out. This is the trailer for GTA 6. Now, mind you, I'm surprised they just haven't slapped M on it and called it a day yet.
Lucia, do you know why you're here?
Bad luck, I guess.
Don't they always say that? And, I mean, it's beautiful. The lighting so far in this trailer is amazing. And then, like, the one thing I really want to point out is, like, look at all of this wildlife. And then on top of that, like, come on. The amount of people on this beach compared to the amount of people that you would have in like GTA 5, it's day and night. There's like probably 20x the amount of people on the beach here for GTA 6 compared to GTA 5. The water physics look good, the lighting looks amazing, but like I said, this is not gameplay. The nightlife. Vice City. Look at the gator. So, this is something I kind of want to check out as well. Like, if you look, there's been quite a few points in this trailer where, like, you're seeing a lot of, like, social media posts or live posts, much like this. So, I'm wondering how much this is going to tie into the game. Because, now, granted, real world, there is a lot of people that are, like, you know, they have to film everything. So I'm kind of wondering, like, will this affect, like, how the cops respond to stuff? Will this affect, like, you know, your reputation level, kind of like they do for Red Dead Redemption? Yeah. It's just interesting. Something to think about. There's another gator. This looks like a raid. Whole bunch of Florida men.
Ah. Well, look who's back.
The only way we're gonna get through this is by sticking together, being a team. Trust?
Trust.
GTA 6. Coming 2025. So, that's the trailer. That's where it ends. So, we know that, of course, we got two main characters here. We got old girl here and homeboy. I'm not sure if it's going to be like GTA 5 where you can switch in between them. I'm not sure if it looks like the chick here is going to be the main character potentially with how much she talked in the trailer. Like I said, I'm very interested to see like how interactive the wildlife's going to be. If it's going to be kind of similar to like how Red Dead Redemption is when it comes to wildlife. Yeah, I'm just kind of disappointed we didn't get any kind of gameplay, considering that they've been working on this game for over 10 years. Don't get me wrong, what we have so far, the cinematics on it, gorgeous. But I'm kind of let down that there was no, no gameplay. And then on top of that, we got to wait potentially 2 years. Like, if it comes out December of 2025, I'm gonna die a little bit on the inside. But I think this game is genuinely going to come out probably September of 25, because most big games, in my opinion, come out in like September timeframe to allow the build up for the holidays. So you get that initial cash grab, and then come Black Friday, they're like, yo, $20 off. But it brings me to my next point. Do you guys think, watching this trailer, that this game's going to be worth the potential price point that they keep throwing out there to see what people are saying, of like between $120 to $150? On top of that, do you think that this game would be worth paying an hourly rate to play? I don't know. Me personally, if I'm going to play the campaign, I think a flat fee of $70, because we're in that age where everything's gone up in price, where $70 is basically the baseline for, you know, a base game nowadays. I'd be okay with spending $70. But anything over that, I may have to wait till a Black Friday sale. But anyways, you guys, hopefully you enjoyed that. Don't forget to mash that like button, subscribe, and let me know down below, what did you think of the launch trailer they did here? Do you think it was a good idea? Do you think it was a bad idea? Or do you just, like, you're indifferent? Anyways, guys, I'll catch you later.